dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment to acknowledge our sins so that we may prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite to a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We ask you, brothers and sisters, with regard to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our assembly with him, not to be shaken out of your minds suddenly, or to be alarmed either by a spirit or by an oral statement, or by a letter allegedly from us to the effect that the day of the Lord is at hand. Let no one deceive you in any way. To this end, he has also called you through our gospel to possess the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, brothers and sisters, stand firm and hold fast to the tradition that you were taught, either by oral statement or by a letter of ours. May our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who has loved us and given us everlasting encouragement and good hope through his grace, encourage your hearts and strengthen them in every good deed and word. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please respond. The Lord comes to judge the earth. Say among the nations, the Lord is King. He has made the world firm, not to be moved. He governs the peoples with equity.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the sea and what fills it resound. Let the plains be joyful and all that is in them. Then shall all the trees of the forest exult.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Before the Lord, he comes. Before the Lord, for he comes to rule the earth. He shall rule the world with justice and the peoples with his consistency.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Alleluia.
Offer our prayers to the Lord.
For all the members of the the church, may Christ keep us faithful to the gospel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all peoples of the world, may the Lord's love and mercy be upon them and bring them salvation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who live each day with fears and anxieties, may the Holy Spirit be their comfort and their strength, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of faith, may God continue to fill us with gifts of grace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, may the Lord welcome them into his eternal peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions we hold deeply in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-living God, hear the prayers in which we have presented here before you. May they be answered in due time, according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessing you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. The fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness may I receive the blood, bread, may I receive the wine we offer you, the fruit of the vine, and work of your hands will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
The Lord redeemed for yourself a people by adoption through the one sacrifice offered once and for all. Bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. And his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, Lord, the font of all holiness. And only therefore these gifts we pray, by sitting down your spirit upon the life of your fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. when we eat this bread
and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks as you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Charles, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. those who are not able to receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer our prayers for you. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament, and I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Complete within us, Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Have a great day.